the lies. Dude, we gotta talk about this. What's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to my channel. Alexis Kimberly here. In today's video, I wanna talk about texturizers. I am a little bit heated right now because as I was prepping this video, I'm like, you know what? There are just so many lies. Lies being told about what texturizers are, about what they do to your hair. We need to set the record straight here. In this video, I'm gonna be talking about texturizers, what they actually are, and some of the marketing choices that these brands are putting out there to get you guys to buy these texturizers under these false pretenses. So definitely stay tuned to the end of this video so we can chat all about that. So let's get straight to the chase. Texturizers are relaxers. Texturizers are relaxers. Now, a texturizer, yes, is supposed to be a milder relaxer, but at its core, a texturizer is a relaxer. The same hydroxide-based chemical that's used in a relaxer is also used in a texturizer. So a texturizer is still a chemical process. It is a permanently altering chemical process that will forever change the texture of your hair. I just want to make that very clear because there are so many women, unfortunately, who are led to believe that texturizers are something different than a relaxer, something that is natural, that will just elongate their tresses and create these ringlet curls for them. And that is just so not true. Now, the problem is that many brands will market their texturizers as a product for natural hair. I literally picked up a product. I went to the beauty supply store. I did my own like little deep dive experiment, and I went to the beauty supply store and I was looking for texturizers. And guys, I can't tell you how many of those products, those boxes that I picked up that said for natural hair or curl loosener, healthy alternative, in some variation or so, they were promoting this product as though it was meant for natural hair. When somebody picks up a product and they read for natural hair, what does that mean for them? That means that this is a product designed for naturals. It's really misleading to make people think that they're going to maintain the integrity of their natural hair by picking up this product, when in actuality, they are picking up a relaxer that contains the same chemical or a slight, you know, milder variation of a relaxer chemical. You know, it's just so misleading. I just cannot stand when brands try to mislead consumers in buying something that like is actually not correct. Like my mind was blown when I saw the texturizer for natural hair. What? For natural hair. That's like imagine if a relaxer box, like you go into the beauty supply store and you pick up a relaxer and it says for natural hair. What? You would never find a relaxer that says for natural hair, because everyone knows good and damn well that a relaxer is not designated or is not targeted at natural hair. If anything, it does the exact opposite, right? It's not for natural hair. It can be for natural hair, but it's really for those who are chemically processing their hair, or at least have made the decision to chemically process their hair, right? So you would never see that, at least I would hope. You would never see that on a relaxer box. So why would we see that on a texturizer box? So I mentioned earlier that a texturizer is marketed as a milder relaxer, which generally I think is true. However, in my little experiment at the beauty supply store, I actually picked up two random products. It was by the same brand, same exact brand, but one was a relaxer and one was a texturizer. And they were just like, it was like perfect. Like they were literally sitting right next to each other. And I was like, huh, look at this. Same brand, relaxer, texturizer. Let me flip this around and look at the ingredients. Guys, the ingredients were exactly the same. Like, you know when you look at the ingredients list on products, and if you don't know, ingredients lists go in the order of concentration. The ingredient with the highest concentration is first, and then the one with the lowest concentration is last. And so I'm looking at the ingredients list and I'm like, relaxer, ingredient A, texturizer, ingredient A. And then I'm looking to the end of the ingredients list and it's literally the exact same thing, which means that they literally are the exact same product in the exact same concentration. And I'm literally trying to figure out what this could possibly mean. Like what can explain this, right? Like, because when you purchase a texturizer, it's with the expectation that it's going to be less harmful than a relaxer. But I'm looking at these products, these two products, and the ingredients list are exactly the same. There's nothing to differentiate the two. And I just literally was just like shocked. Like this is crazy. Like you're literally marketing a product that is the exact replica of a relaxer as a texturizer. And another thing dealing with texturizers is, again, this notion that texturizers, curl looseners, texture softeners are gentler on the hair. A lot of times it'll have a child on the front of the box. And when you look at the child, you're like, wow, look how cute and gentle this child is. How harmful could this product actually be? There's a baby on the cover. There's a baby. It's gotta be good. It's gotta be gentle, right? No, it's not. I look at the back of these texturizers, these curl softeners, these, you know, whatever. And a lot of them actually have lye in them. But there are a lot of people who choose box relaxers or texturizers because they're no lye based. Like it's a no lye formula. Because there's a notion that no lye is gentler than lye. But if you look at the texturizer ingredients, a lot of them have lye in them. A lot of them have that sodium hydroxide ingredient in them. And if you're not paying attention, you may be thinking that you're picking up a no lye texturizer when in fact, you're picking up a mild lye relaxer. Nobody talks about that. And the brands market it as a healthy alternative when in fact, again, it's the same lye relaxer that people are like, ooh, scared of. And now I use a lye relaxer, so I am fine with a product having lye in it. But I'm speaking on behalf of people who take issue with lye relaxers and find them to be a little bit too aggressive on their hair or on their scalp. And if your intention is to go with a no lye relaxer, then honey, you need to read those ingredients, because I picked up a few products that were marketed as texturizers. And in fact, they had sodium hydroxide in them as like the fifth ingredient on the list. And or sixth ingredient on the list, something like that. And yeah, it's a that's a lye relaxer, honey. That's a lye relaxer. Now the other thing that I want to just mention briefly is the idea that when you texturize your hair, you are going to wind up with a looser, wider curl pattern, and that's just not gonna be the case. You are, when you Texlax or when you texturize your hair, you are elongating the natural curl pattern of your hair. Meaning that if you took your natural kinky coil hair and you stretch it, make it elongated, make it longer, that's what's going to be the result of your Texlax hair, of your texturized hair. Because you're not going to change the structure of your hair. You're only going to elongate the natural curl pattern. So when I was thinking about going Texlax back in the day, I was like, ooh, I'm gonna have these like cute little curls and they're gonna pop and spring up. Like they have these like cute little 3C curls. They're not. My hair is not like that. It did not turn out like that. My hair is still type 4 and it still has its, you know, its kinks and bends that it naturally would have if I was natural. Again, it's just elongated. And if anything, in my personal experience with Texlax hair, you actually have less uniformity with your hair now that your hair has been chemically altered, because unless you are like, you know, super on it and you get the exact same relaxed results or Texlax or texturized, whatever you want to call it, result every time you texturize your hair, you are going to have some level of variation between relaxer services. But in truth, just get out of your mind this idea that you're going to have these spiral 3C wet curls that are just gonna spring and just be something that your natural hair never was. The other thing that I want to kind of point out or just address is the notion that people can use texturizers to transition from relaxed hair to natural hair. And I just think that that's a little bit like silly because you're using a chemical to transition to a non-chemical natural state. Your goal is to get from relaxed hair to natural hair. With relaxed hair, you have a chemical in your hair. And so your thought process or the thought process is that you're going to use a texturizer to gradually get you there. But you're literally using the same chemical in the texturizer that you were using for your relaxer. So you're not getting any closer to being natural, like at all. You're just actually prolonging the process to become fully natural. I think that maybe the thought process is that it eases the transition to natural hair, but I think that there's not enough conversation about what that actually looks like and what that would actually do to your hair. Texlaxing is no joke, and when you combine having relaxed ends with your Texlax transitioning hair along with your new growth, it becomes very, very cumbersome and a very, very difficult thing to maintain. So my suggestion, you should just stop taking, using relaxers and just transition the ordinary traditional way of just, stopping the chemical processes, doing protective styles to maintain those two textures, and ultimately doing a big chop into natural hair. So bottom line is yes, you can get a texturizer from the store, purchase it and use it and get amazing Texlax results. I'm not saying that you can't, but I just want to make you guys aware of what these brands are doing. I know that some of you were having some kinds of like questions about texturizers, so just be very aware of the products that you're using, the ingredients on the back of the box, look at the ingredients, see the concentration, compare the relaxer product to the texturizer. Are the ingredients really different? Is the active ingredient further down the list than the other ingredients? Just take a second to really just do your research before you decide on what texturizer you are going to use, okay? Okay. If you have any other questions, then definitely let me know. But in the meantime, I will see you all in my next video. All right, bye guys.